thing you would see if you came up to our show on the Midway is you would see what is called the outside talker, sometimes derogatorily referred to as a barker. So we're going to start off the show the exact same way that you would see it on the Midway. So welcome out to the stage, Mr. Odd Corey.
Thank you so very, very much. So, ladies and gentlemen, as the young lady just told you, my name is Odd Corey, and I would be on the outside of the tent standing on a stage known as the Bally Stage, and I am performing what is called the Bally. So as all you fine folks and your families are walking up and down the Midway, what you would hear would be a little something like this. Well, ladies and gentlemen, come on over. Step right in. The big show is just about to begin. Ladies and gentlemen, on the inside, you're going to see 12 big acts today. You're going to see amazing performers, live entertainers congregated right here in your hometown, not to scare, but to entertain each and every one of you. You're going to meet interesting people on the inside like our human blockhead. Now, how many of you folks have ever seen a human blockhead before? Show of hands. Anybody? Oh, man, I came to the wrong town. Now, folks, for those of you that did not raise your hand and don't know, a human blockhead is a bizarre individual that you'll see on the inside of our show that rams, jams, and crams solid steel spikes directly into the center of their face. They do it over and over and over again for your entertainment. It's absolutely amazing. You're going to see a sword swallower tonight, folks. You're going to watch this young man, the real deal, ingest over 2.5 feet of solid steel blade all the way down into his stomach. He swallows swords, sabers, bayonets, and a whole lot more. And I mean much more. It's absolutely incredible. You really must see it to believe it, folks. You're actually going to get to meet the young woman that we call Miss Electra today. Aren't you excited, folks? Now, yeah. Now, this young lady actually suffered a very serious accident when she was very, very young. Now, if you look up the newspaper articles in the archives from her hometown, you can actually trace all of this from the beginning. I'm dead serious. Now, folks, this young lady in about 1994, when she was about 6 years old, was actually struck by lightning. She does actually bear a bizarre mark from the lightning strike, although she is a little bit shy, so she may not show it to you. But we're going to do a live demonstration of this amazing thing that she has since been able to do after her long, extensive recovery from this, folks. Now, this young lady can actually channel electrical current throughout her body, and we're going to do a live demonstration using this real working model of Thomas Edison's electric chair. Now, folks, here in just a second, you're going to meet the young woman that we call the Queen of Kerosene. And that's because she drinks burning gasoline like you and I might share a nice Coca-Cola on a hot day at the fair like today. So, ladies and gentlemen, without further ado, please welcome out to the stage our goddess of fire, JuJu. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it for Miss Juju. Definitely the hottest girl at the fair. All right, what do you folks think of that? All right, now, folks, the next thing that's going to be performed before you is actually a famous act that was popularized in the mid-1990s by a man named Melvin Burkhart after his nose was broken during a boxing match. It was originated in the late 1800s by a man named Arthur Plumhaw, who was later known as the King of Torture. Now, folks, the very first time that I ever performed this, it was in front of my poor, dear mother. God bless the woman. Now, my mother, the first time she ever witnessed this, she looked me dead in the eyes and she said, as she stroked her mustache, "We look a lot alike." She said, "Corey, I really needed to see that like I needed a hole in the head," which is actually kind of ironic because without one, I wouldn't be able to do this. Now, folks, what I have in my hand right here is a solid steel 20-penny steel nail. What I have here is a wooden mallet. Now, to be more specific, this is a crab mallet. I may not have mentioned before, but I actually hail from the state of Maryland. You never know when you're going to get crabs. We're crazy about them down there. Now, folks, what I'm going to do with this mallet and this nail is I'm going to use the mallet to drive the nail for your viewing entertainment directly into the center of my face. Is that something you folks would like to see? This is how they roll and call, and you people are sick. And I love every minute of it. Now, folks, what we're going to do is I'm going to take the nail, I'm going to hold it up here to the center of my face, and then on the count of three, we're all going to go crazy, and I'm going to drive the nail into the center of my face. Are you ready? One, two, three. I don't have a single friend here. You guys were just going to let me do that. Well, folks, to be honest with you, I might be crazier than a sack of ferrets, but I'm not stupid. Now, you see, this actually isn't the center of my face. Now, if you follow a vertical axis down and a horizontal axis across, that puts the center of my face right about here. So right now, the nail is about halfway into my sinus cavity, and it's about a quarter of an inch right below where the stem of my brain actually meets my own spine. Let me hear you make some noise if you want to see me drive it the rest of the way in. Yeah, why not? Whoa. All right, we are all the way back in there. I think I just forgot out. Now, here comes the fun part, folks, the extraction. And for those of you in the front row, this isn't SeaWorld, but there is a splash zone. There it is. No fuss, no muss. Don't worry, I was just checking for blood, but it's not. As you can imagine, my mother absolutely hated me doing that every single time, and she still hates it today, but as it turns out, she's not actually mad about me picking my nose, it's that I'm not using the proper instrumentation. Ladies and gentlemen, back in the day, before we had modern instruments like the ice maker in the refrigerator, you had to have a large block of ice actually delivered to your own home, and you would break it up with a hammer and one of these, and it was called an ice pick. I call it a nose pick. That is the best impression of Pinocchio that I can do. Now, I can tell a few of you are concerned about my well-being. You don't have to worry. Can you see right on the tip of that? That's what we call peace of mind. Never mind, it's a booger. My bad. Now, as you can imagine, every single time I do that, it just leaves me even more congested. I push all the mucus all the way into the far back of my sinus cavity. Now, I'm going to give you folks a piece of advice. The next time you find yourself that congested, don't reach up in the cupboard for that neti pot. I want you to get yourself a 20-volt cordless DeWalt power drill. Oh, goodness, I can breathe again. That's absolutely wonderful. Ladies and gentlemen, my name is Odd Corey, and this is my rendition of what we call the human blockhead. Thank you very much. Now, by now, I'm quite certain that you folks have been eyeballing some of this most luxurious-looking furniture that you see on the stage right here behind me. Well, I assure you folks that this furniture may be luxurious, but it is nowhere near ordinary. Now, to my left here, folks, we have a ladder. Not an ordinary ladder, mind you. This ladder has had every single rung replaced with razor sharp machetes. That's right, JuJu. Razor sharp. And now, folks, we're going to give you a live demonstration right now on how to use a crazy ladder such as this. But in order to do that, please welcome back out one more time the lovely, the amazing Miss JuJu. Noise if you want to see her go higher. Nothing on the bottom of the feet, folks. No protection whatsoever, just bare tootsie. JuJu and her amazing feet.
Oh, thank you guys very much. Now, we do have another strange contraption to show you. Corey, if you wouldn't mind grabbing that out, what we have over here. Oh, little cowboy moment. What we have here, folks, is an ordinary, everyday, completely average, or as average as they can be, bed of nails. What makes this bed of nails so much more interesting is this is actually the same bed of nails that Odd Corey's dad made him sleep in when he was a kid. He said that sleeping on this bed of nails, it would make Corey tough. It would make Corey strong. But all it did was make him weird. But he's going to demonstrate this for you folks, and in order to do that, he's going to remove the one layer of protection that he has against his back and the nails. And that is his shirt. You can applaud for that. I do. All right, and what he's going to do is he's going to gently place himself down and lay across this bed of pointy, sharp nails. You can applaud for that. Now, what he's doing right now is he's evenly distributing his weight across his nails, and that's fairly impressive because it's very uncomfortable, but we want to make this more impressive, right? So in order to do that, we're going to have to disrupt the equilibrium of his body, and in order to do that, we're going to need a volunteer from the audience. Anybody? Single volunteer. You know what, Shango, why don't you come up here? You'd be perfect. Come on, Shango. Everyone give Shango a big round of applause. All right, what I'm going to have you do is you're going to step, if you can, kind of step behind him a little. What I'm going to have you do is I'm going to give you a hand to help you up, and I want you to do one hand, one foot right here, and the other one right here. Now strike a pretty pose. Everyone give it up for Shingo! Now get him off you. Now step down. There you go. Excellent. Kevin, give it up for Mr. Shango, everyone. Corey just got Shango-tized. Well, we do have one more thing to disrupt the equilibrium of Odd Corey while he lays on his bed of nails. This is a 91-pound... No, wait. 16-pound bowling ball. All right, I'm going to drop it from above my head right onto his stomach. Do you guys want to see that? Yeah. You have no friends in this audience.
I don't know friends anywhere. Who let me do this?
I need to get three
counts before I drop
this. Are you guys all ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready for
this?
Three, two, one.
Oh!
Everybody give it up again for Odd Corey, the pain-proof man. All right. So the next thing that we have is a little bit big, so I'm going to stall for just a second. You guys want to hear me tell a joke? Oh, excellent. I've been hoping that I got to tell this. So we're here at Magic Week, and so this joke is about my favorite thing, a magician. So this magician goes to this hometown, goes to this small town, right? He's on tour, and he's got this itty-bitty town between two big cities, and he decides that this is the perfect place to test a new routine. So it's grand night. He does his whole big act. Everyone's all applauding, and at the very end, he's like, now, for you folks here, I'm going to do something special. I'm going to do something I've never done on stage before, and in order to do this, I'm going to need a volunteer from the audience. I'm going to need the biggest, strongest man out there. Well, this man stands up in the audience. He's about 6'3", 250 pounds of pure muscle. Guy's like, I believe that's me. Magician looks him up and down, and he's like, yeah, sir, no, I believe that's you. Come up on stage. So the big man comes up on stage, and the magician hands him a sledgehammer. He tells him very clearly, he was like, what I need you to do is I need you to take this sledgehammer, swing it back as hard as you can, and crack me right here, right in the skull. The big man's like, I don't want to do that. I don't want to do that. And the magician's like, no, trust me, I'm a magician. That's why you shouldn't trust magicians, by the way. So he says, trust me, I'm a magician. The big man says, no, I'm afraid that's going to kill you. And the magician's like, look, I have this legal document all drawn up. I have it signed here. You sign right there. It absolves you of all responsibility if anything goes wrong. Big man's like, okay, yeah, sure. I'll go ahead and do it. So he takes the sledgehammer, swings it back real far, cracks the magician right in the skull. Magician falls, hits the stage, pool of blood starts spilling out. Everyone's thinks it's part of the act, so they're all quiet, waiting for him to come back up. Magician doesn't pop back up. Big man standing up there with a sledgehammer in his head, and he's like, guys, he's not getting up. Something's seriously wrong. So the EMTs come, they rush him off to the hospital. They don't even know this magician's real name, so they're not sure what to do with him, so they just stick him in a room and monitor him. Hopefully, he gets better. They have him stabilized. So about 3 months goes by. Guy hasn't had any changes in his condition, but all of a sudden, one day, his eyes start moving underneath his eyelids. Nurse gets real excited, calls in the doctor. Doctor, we see some brain movement. The doctor's like, oh, goodness, he might come through. He might come out of this. Just, we're going to keep monitoring him around the clock. So about a week goes by. The eyes are moving. He's being monitored around the clock. And then one day, his eyes start to open a little bit. Nurse gets real excited. She calls in the doctor. She's like, doctor, his eyes are opening. Doctor rushes into the room. A bunch of other nurses rush into the room. They've all been waiting for this magician to wake up for 3 whole months. Magician starts opening his eyes slowly, blinks a few times, looks around the room, and says, ta-da.
Ladies and gentlemen, for that, I do sincerely apologize. Next time, I'll try to be a lot faster. All right, now, ladies and gentlemen, what we're going to present to you right now is actually one of the oldest sideshow traditions that started right here in the great old United States of America. So, folks, for just a moment, I want to turn all of your attention to this beautiful big blue box. Now, you see, normally, this would be about a break in the middle of our regular show out on the Midway, and we would bring out this box and turn everyone's attention to it just like we have for you. Now, notice that there is absolutely nothing under the box. I rolled it out here on wheels. There's no smoke, no mirrors, no gimmicks. Nothing but feet and floor. Now, if you look closely, when I open the lid, notice that the lid has actually very large holes and small slots in it. Large holes and small slots. We're going to get back to that here in just a moment. Now, there are actually two locks on the inside that I must disengage, and that allows the front of the box to completely open up. That way you can see that there is absolutely nothing inside of the box. Well, folks, that is because far lovelier than the box itself is what we're actually going to be putting into it. Now, you met her just a moment ago, and she's the only other person back here, so you don't really have a choice. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back out to the stage the lovely JuJu. We work with what we've got. Now, JuJu, the loveliest of ladies, is going to have herself a seat in the box right over here. She's actually then going to lay down inside the box. Yeah, that works too. Yeah, get in there. Don't be afraid. Now, kids, go ahead and say goodbye to JuJu, because I'm actually going to close the front of the box, and that's the last you're going to see of her for just a little while. Both locks on the inside of the box will be engaged. And then I'm actually going to close the lid, completely concealing JuJu on the inside. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is how I get myself a girlfriend. She's been with me for over 2 years. I should never let her out of the box, though. Now, folks, get in there. This is my time. Now, folks, what we did not tell you about the lovely JuJu is that she is actually an eighth-generation performer known as a contortionist. That's right, folks, a contortionist. Now, if you don't know what a contortionist is, that is a very unique style of entertainer with an uncanny, or in this case, even an unnatural ability to twist and bend and writhe in all sorts of crazy positions not even yet documented in the Kama Sutra. Now, folks, remember those slots that we showed you in the lid? There are actually 14 of those slots, and that's because right here behind me are 14 razor sharp blades. That's right, JuJu, razor sharp. Each and every blade is just a little bit longer than the box actually is deep, so you can actually look underneath and see the box or the blades penetrate all the way through. They don't bend, they don't fold, they don't retract in any way. So with that being said, we're gonna get busy, and I'm gonna go ahead and insert the first blade right over here where the young lady's head was. Now, this may not seem too impressive at first, folks, but with every blade that I insert into the box, there's roughly 6 square inches of space that she no longer has inside the box to occupy, which means that she has to wiggle, move, and finagle herself around in order to dodge these sharp blades. Now, folks, if she is not quick enough, if she does not respond within just the fraction of a second, she could actually sustain a moderate injury from this, folks, and it can actually get quite serious. More than just ripping her pretty costume, we can actually nick an artery or even sever a tendon. Or, worse yet, I could give her a bad haircut and then I'd never hear the end of it. So we're going to try to avoid that as much as possible. Now, folks, if you could see this from my perspective, it would just absolutely blow your mind. What I can see in here, folks, maybe it's just because I'm over the age of 30, but just watching her do this makes my own back hurt. I feel like I'm getting scoliosis. She's twisting, she's bending, and she's writhing herself around these crazy blades inside this box, similar in fashion to that of a large jungle snake wrapping itself around the branch of a tree. It's absolutely mind-boggling. Now, this is where things start to get a little hairy, so I'm going to shave some off. These are the three largest blades that go into the box. One straight down through the clavicle and breastplate. Another one through the legs. And if things weren't getting confusing enough, right here, straight down through the middle. Now, this is normally the part of the show, folks, where everybody just assumes that we have diverted their attention. It's a magic trick, and we've somehow escaped the girl from the box, and she's no longer in there. Raise your hands if you think we've snuck her out of the box. I shouldn't even have bothered asking a room full of magicians. So, ladies and... get out of here! I've had about enough of you. Now, folks, here's the real question is, how many of you want to see how this trick is done? All right, we do have a couple. I had a feeling that you might. See, the other shows, anybody that would present something even remotely close to this, they don't want you to know how it's done. But we are not like those other shows, folks. Oh, no, we are not. We're actually going to give you a glorious peek into this great secret of the Sideshow. You see, the lovely JuJu, like I said before, is an eighth-generation performer. And what that means is that she travels all over the country and beyond. This box, along with her amazing skills, have been handed down mother to daughter for over 100 years, folks. And now she is a guest on this show just for this week only. So that means she is not paid by this show, folks. Oh, no. What that means is that her livelihood is completely fueled by your generosity. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you raised your hand and you said, you want to see how this trick is done? You remember those big holes in the lid? Those are for your eyes, so you can actually see down into the box and see her twisted all around these crazy blades. You're going to see all of Miss JuJu, folks, and I do mean all of Miss JuJu. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you want to learn this amazing secret of the Sideshow, go ahead and start lining up right here in the middle. We're going to let everybody come up and actually take a look inside the box. Now, folks, in exchange for learning this amazing secret of the Sideshow, we are going to actually ask you for a very small token of your appreciation. Now, that, folks, that a token of your appreciation will be no less than $1. That's right, a dollar you will forget about before you even leave the show, but what you see inside the box will burn an image into your mind that will last you a lifetime. I absolutely guarantee it. So, folks, if you are in line and you have your dollar ready, I'm going to give you a couple quick rules. First rule, please, whatever you do, do not touch the box. It is the oldest thing on our show, next to JuJu. Now, the second thing you definitely don't want to do is touch the girl. We are all about consent here at the Sideshow, and I'm sorry, fellas, you just don't have it. Come back to the 10 o'clock show. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you are in line, you have your dollar ready, I invite you to go ahead, step right on up. You're going to drop your dollar straight into the bucket, and then you're going to take all the time you need looking inside the box, where you're going to see this crazy lady tied up amongst all those blades. That's right, folks. Our wonderful contortionist, she is twisted herself into more knots than a sailor can tie, and it's absolutely amazing. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this is one of the greatest and oldest American traditions there is, because it started right here in this great country of ours, and we thank you so much for helping us celebrate the greatest nation in the world, which is the donation, ladies and gentlemen. And for that, we thank you very, very much. Now, folks, we're going to do last call. If you want a chance to see this amazing thing inside the box, going once, three, two. Oh, we got a couple of more, and we've got so much more show for you, folks. You're still going to meet the Sword Swallower and all the other crazy people hanging out backstage. They're probably feeding our Spider Girl and getting ready to come out here in just a moment. Now, you don't have to be scared, little lady. You just go ahead and you drop your contribution right there into the bucket. You take all the time you need. She'll let you know that she is in there like swimwear, and she just can't wait to meet you. Look at her. She's in there. She's twisted, and she is bent. Well, she's definitely twisted. Please take a souvenir cucumber with you on your way out. All right, folks, that's going to be last call. We're going to go ahead and do 3, 2, 1. All right, I'm going to pull the blades out in lightning fast speeds in no particular order. Same rules apply. If you'd like, kids, help me count down from the number 14. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. I think I started counting back up. I was never good at math. I clearly didn't go to college. Why else would I be here? All right, folks, now I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to open the lid. Then we're going to disengage both locks on the inside, allowing you to see all of Miss JuJu. We're going to see if she's okay, folks. There she is, completely intact, totally unscathed, and absolutely amazing as always. Thank you very much, folks. Now, this is normally where we would turn your kind attention back to the main stage where our show would continue, while probably the knife juggler would be setting up and everyone would stop looking at me. But here I am, and you have no choice. So, JuJu, I'm going to give you a little bit of a push right there, and we'll just get that back out of the way. Please stand by.